games about rainbows and fluffy bunnies are fine, but if you're a serious video game fan, at some point you're gonna wanna shoot something. Gamers have been shooting at stuff since the earliest days of computers, and that tradition continues today in Scratch, where you'll find literally millions of games that involve firing some kind of projectile. To create projectiles in Scratch, you'll need to learn a little bit about clones. Clones are temporary copies of regular sprites that are really handy when you need to create a whole squadron of bad guys or a storm of missiles. Activating this block will create a copy of a sprite in the exact same coordinates where the original sprite lives on the screen. The new sprite is temporary, meaning you can zap it out of existence using this block. Any sprite in your project can create clones of any other sprite, but it can be a little dangerous if you tell Scratch to create clones of myself. As this example shows, our cloned rabbits will also make clones of themselves, and things very quickly get comical. In this simple tank game, we're going to solve that problem by having our tank sprite do the clone making. We'll tell it to create a new shell every time we press the space key. We're creating clones now, but they're just sitting there doing nothing. To order our clones around, we need to drop one of these hat blocks, called When I Started the Clone, into our projectile sprite. Let's tell our bullet that once it's created, it should start playing a sound and then move at a speed of 10. We want it to keep moving, so we'll keep repeating that action until our shell touches the edge of the screen. When it touches the edge, we'll tell it to delete itself. Our new clones are being created on top of the original tank shell, so let's fix that by inserting a block that tells each new clone to go to the tank's current position. Okay, our tank is shooting nicely, but watch what happens when I turn my tank. To fix this problem, we need to make our shell face in the same direction as our tank before it starts moving. One easy way to do that is with this light blue block called the reporter block. The reporter block is a really handy tool that gives your sprites information about what other sprites in your project are up to. In this case, we want to find out which direction our tank is facing. If we place this block inside a direction block, we can get our tank shell to spin around and face the same direction as our tank. Now we're ready to tear up the battlefield. In our next episode, we'll look at how to make our projectiles blow stuff up.
I see over the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.